Friends, in the passage that I'm about to share with you, the famous Lebanese poet Khalil Gibran shares some profound wisdom on overcoming your fears by letting go of your ego and duality and by merging and becoming one with the Supreme Consciousness. He wrote, "It is said that before entering the sea, it is said that before entering the sea, a river trembles with fear. She looks back at the path she has traveled, from the peaks of the mountains, the long winding road crossing forests and villages. And in front of her, she sees an ocean so vast that to enter there seems nothing more than to disappear forever. But there is no other way. But there is no other way. The river cannot go back. Nobody can go back. To go back is impossible in existence. The river needs to take the risk of entering the ocean, because only then will the fear disappear. Because only then will the fear disappear, because that's where the river will know. It's not about disappearing into the ocean, but of becoming the ocean." I think this is worth repeating, because that's where the river will know. It's not about disappearing into the ocean, but of becoming the ocean. Khalil Gibran. Friends, don't be scared when death knocks at your door, because what seems like the end of a journey is an act of merging back with the Supreme Source from where we all originated. And no one can escape that. No one can go back. So don't be scared and don't be too attached to your worldly accomplishments and possessions. And you don't even have to wait for death to achieve this state of oneness and detachment. You can practice what Dr. Wayne Dyer often referred to as dying while you're still alive. Dying while you're still alive. Practicing detachment and merging your identity and your ego with the Supreme Source. And then, as it's written in the Bhagavad Gita, everything will be yours and you will belong to everyone. Everything will be yours and you will belong to everyone. I leave you with this profound thought from the Indian Hindu saint and religious leader, Sri Ramakrishna Paramahansa, who wrote, "Spirituality automatically leads to humility. Spirituality automatically leads to humility. When a flower develops into a fruit, the petals drop off on their own. And when one becomes spiritual, the ego vanishes gradually on its own. A tree laden with fruit always bends low. Humility is a sign of greatness. Humility is a sign of greatness." Sri Ramakrishna Paramahansa. Don't forget, friends, when entering the ocean, upon entering the ocean, the river is not losing its identity. It's rejoining its source, and it's now transforming into the mighty ocean. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.